Welcome back, everyone, now to this 31st chapter to the book of Proverbs, this climactic 31st chapter, the end of this study together in the book of Proverbs. We made it to the last chapter, but we know this is not the end, but merely the beginning. This has been a privilege and an honor to join together and to go along this journey of wisdom and growing in faith and in righteousness and in the love of God. Yet, as we go forth, may we always continue to study the Word, continue to study the book of Proverbs, and to go as the Lord leads us and guides us and strengthens us to be more like His Son, Jesus Christ. This chapter is dealing with the great topic of a noble and godly wife and a noble and godly woman. And there's many other warnings here as well, but let us take to heart that this applies to everybody, not just the wife, but even the child of God as a whole, men and women alike, as all of us are referred to as believers, the bride of Christ. Let us pray and enter into this last chapter and hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to His people today, because we need this word now like never before, that we may go along the narrow path of Christ Jesus. Father, we thank You for Your words. We thank You for Your love. We thank You for Your heart and Your truth and Your righteousness. I thank You for this whole book of Proverbs and for guiding us and leading us and empowering us to get to this point. I praise You, Lord, for teaching us and showing us Your truth throughout these Proverbs. And I know that You shall continue on this journey on earth as well as through all of eternity. I just pray for the grace, Lord, that we would all understand what You're saying to us, that we would all grow with You personally and in a deeper relationship with You through Jesus, and that we would love You more intimately and truly as we ought to. Have Your way. And may this word be impactful to our hearts, that we would apply it in our lives and truly bear fruit to Your glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank You, Yahweh. Amen. Amen, amen. All right, chapter 31, verse 1 of Proverbs states, "The words of King Lemuel, the oracle, which his mother taught him. What, O my son, and what, O son of my womb, and what, O son of my vows? Do not give your strength to women, or your ways to that which destroys kings. It is not for kings, O Lemuel. It is not for kings to drink wine, or for rulers to desire strong drink. Verse 5, lest they drink and forget what is decreed, and pervert the rights of all the afflicted. Give strong drink to him who is perishing, and wine to him whose life is bitter. Let him drink and forget his poverty, and remember his trouble no more. Open your mouth for the dumb, for the rights of all the unfortunate. Open your mouth, judge righteously, and defend the rights of the afflicted and needy." Verse 10 now. "An excellent wife, who can find? For her worth is far above jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not evil all the days of her life. She looks for wool and flax and works with her hands in delight. She is like merchant ships. She brings her food from afar. She rises also while it is still night and gives food to her household and portions to her maidens. She considers a field and buys it from her earnings. She plants a vineyard." Verse 17. "She girds herself with strength and makes her arms strong. She senses that her gain is good. Her lamp does not go out at night. She stretches out her hand to the distaff, and her hands grasp the spindle. She extends her hand to the poor, and she stretches out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. She makes coverings for herself. Her clothing is fine linen and purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sits among the elders of the land. She makes linen garments and sells them and supplies belts to the tradesmen." Verse 25. "Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she smiles at the future. She opens her mouth in wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and bless her, her husband also, and he praises her, saying, "Many daughters have done nobly, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord or reverences the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her the product of her hands and let her works praise her in the gates." Amen. This concludes the 31st chapter and the book of Proverbs as a whole. But let us look here. As we see the 31st chapter, we really see from verses 10 through 31 as the description of a worthy woman, but even the verses prior to that in the exhortations to the son from the mother, which we could say would be even wisdom unto us by the Holy Spirit. But we see here in this whole chapter, these 31 verses, a collection of basically the summation of all of the book of Proverbs combined in one livelihood. Think about it for a moment, that we see wickedness contrasted with righteousness. Because what here is indeed the right way and what opposite must be true to be the wrong way. But we see all the do things, all the good fruits, all the right paths pursued and fulfilled in this godly woman. It doesn't speak as much to that of the wickedness or as much as that in what not to do as it does as to showing a life well lived in doing that in which is right to do. We can all glean and take something from this description. We can all glean and take something from this word of the Lord. We can all receive and believe and grow in the righteousness of Jesus Christ as we look at this beautiful example of a woman of God. We see that this woman cannot be separated from that of her husband and her husband from that of her. Now, physically speaking, men, we as men of God should be examples in which are so forth bringing a light into the lives of our wives, in which we see we're no longer two but one, but that they follow our example and our lead and our covering by the covering of Christ over us, and then live thus as this states. And we see that the husband also praises her and has respect at the city gates among the people. See, righteousness and favor and grace of the Lord abounds in a family, in a marriage, in a household, and it flows on to the other members, whether deserved or not. Well, we know grace is undeserved favor. But we see this woman is changed. This woman lives in a way that produces good fruit. And we know that that comes from abiding in God. We see this woman trusts the Lord and does not fear. This woman loves the Lord. But because of that love for the Lord, that there is due diligence. There is good consequence. There is reward for labor. That she's not idle, but diligent. Does not eat the bread of idleness, as it says in verse 27, but looks well after the ways of her household. We see in verse 30 even greater that charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. This woman did not seek after vanity and beauty or charm, which was deceitful, but she feared the Lord and she surely was praised by the community, by God loved her and showed his favor on her life. But we see also that the children raised up and blessed her, and the husband also praised her and blessed her, saying that many daughters have done nobly, but you excel them all. So we need to know, men of God here, as I'm speaking to now, that we are to be examples to our wives that they would live like this. Now, are we responsible for everybody's behavior and attitudes and if they live like this or not? Not at all. We're responsible for our own hearts. But we should still receive this as how to live as even a man of God, being diligent with our hands. And we are spiritually moving from physically, as the bride of Christ, all of us can see that this applies and that we want this effect on our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as our bridegroom, who's coming again to receive a bride blameless and blemish free. So we need to know what it is to truly live and exalt our God and to be an excellent companion, even to the Lord. It says, who can find? Her worth is far above jewels. Well, we know that that is what wisdom is. We know that that was what the word of God is. A treasure beyond jewels, a treasure beyond rubies, a treasure beyond gems, beyond silver, beyond gold. That is the word, the priceless word of God. So let us abide in Jesus, the living word, and have his word so abiding in us that we are like this excellent wife, that we are like this excellent example of godliness and living for the Lord. And all of these verses can be broken down into spiritual parabolic form that have great teaching, that have great lessons, that have great example to us all here today. I know I'm speaking, but this is a word we must receive because God is faithful and he gave us this word to conclude the whole book of Proverbs. And as we go into this study now, we see too that warning of avoiding wasting our strength on women, avoiding wasting our strength on wine and alcohol and intoxicants. Why are these two mentioned? Well, both will lead astray, and because of those things can lead into every other wicked way, every other idolatrous and wicked path by giving our hearts to women, plural there, and also even a woman, singular, if they're not what verses 10 through 31 states as an excellent, worthy woman of God. If we're seeking women of vain beauty and deceitful charm, we will be led away and deceived, as Proverbs 6, 7, and 8 state of the woman of folly and the woman of wisdom. We know that we need God, and we know that we do not need to follow in pursuit after mankind who will lead us down the path, the broad road to hell. Jesus came to set us free. So let us not seek those in which will lead us away from God, but let us find those who are walking close to God as the excellent wife here in this 31st chapter of Proverbs, and make companions of those who are wise and not those who are fools. And let us stay far away from any intoxication and be sober-minded and walking soberly and dedicating our time to prayer, to fasting, to seeking God and being an example in these last days, because the time is at hand. Today is the day of salvation. And I'll say it again, today is the day of repentance. We are to live godly lives of repentance, continual, as the Lord reveals to us things we need to change. Let us indeed change and be continuing to grow in the way of the Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, his Son. Amen. Thank you for bearing with me. Let's enter into this study. In verse 1, we see that little is known about Lemuel except that he was a king who received wise teachings from his mother. His name means devoted to God. Some believe that Lemuel and Hagor were both from the kingdom of Massa in northern Arabia. That's pretty powerful. I just learned that. You would think, hey, you're teaching this, you're preaching on this chapter 31 of Proverbs. You should know probably what Lemuel means. But no, that's pretty powerful stuff. It means devoted to God. Let us continue now. Verses 4 through 7, we find that drunkenness might be understandable among dying people in great pain, but it is inexcusable for national leaders. Alcohol clouds the mind and can lead to injustice and poor decisions. Leaders have better things to do than anesthetize themselves with alcohol. Now, I probably pronounced that wrong, but it's okay. You know, you get the drift, that they duel their senses and go astray into a dishonoring mind state and heart and live rebelliously. We don't need these things. Just because something is legal does not mean it's good. Remember that. Let's repeat that. Just because something is legal does not mean that it is good. Verses 10 through 31. Proverbs has a lot to say about women. How fitting that the book ends with a picture of a woman of strong character, great wisdom, many skills, and great compassion. Some people have the mistaken idea that the ideal woman in the Bible is referring or retiring, servile, and entirely domestic. Not so. This woman is an excellent wife and mother. She is also a manufacturer, importer, manager, realtor, farmer, seamstress, upholsterer, and merchant. Her strength and dignity do not come from her amazing achievements, however. They are a result of her reverence for God, as we previously stated. In our society, where physical appearance counts for so much, it may surprise us to realize that her appearance is never mentioned. Her attractiveness comes entirely from her character. The woman described in this chapter has outstanding abilities. Her family's social position is high. In fact, she may not be one woman at all. She may be a composite portrait of ideal womanhood. Do not see her as a model to imitate in every detail. Your days are not long enough to do everything she does. See her instead as an inspiration to be all you can be. We can't be just like her, but we can learn from her industry, integrity, and resourcefulness. Let's repeat that. That's an interesting thought, huh? See her instead as an inspiration to be all you can be. We can't be just like her, but we can learn from her industry, integrity, and resourcefulness. Hallelujah. But let us indeed, number one lesson from her life, fear God, reverence, and respect Him, and pursue Him with all that we have. Amen. In verse 19, we find that the distaff and spindle are two implements used in hand spinning, so making her own fabrics. And also to mention on that is that of her fabric being used there was that of purple, a royal color. So the linens that she had were purple, and that is powerful because those are a color of royalty, and we see that plainly throughout the scriptures and even through historical context. So let us just see that spiritually, how we're made royalty in Christ Jesus as heirs to the throne of grace. In verse 31, to conclude, the book of Proverbs begins with the command to fear the Lord, chapter 1, verse 7, and ends with the picture of a woman who fulfills this command. Her qualities are mentioned throughout the book: hard work, fear of God, respect for spouse, foresight, encouragement, care for others, concern for the poor, wisdom in handling money. These qualities, when coupled with fear of God, lead to enjoyment, success, honor, and worth. Proverbs is very practical for our day because it shows us how to become wise, make good decisions, and live according to God's ideal. Amen. We are going to conclude with that because that practically says everything needed to be said. We can continue to talk and talk and talk and talk, but we get the imagery, we get the point, and throughout the whole book, we've driven and dove into many different forms of what wickedness is, and what righteousness is, and what it means to follow Jesus, what the gospel message is, and what it means to walk in the way of the Spirit and not the way of the flesh. So I just pray, and I'm going to pray now for each and every one of us, that we would walk in wisdom, that we would not walk in folly, that we would walk by the Spirit and not by the flesh, that we would walk by faith and not by sight. If you're in agreement with this prayer, if you desire these things, to look more like Jesus and not like the world, please join with me in faith and let us pray and petition Father God at the throne of grace and mercy, trusting that He hears us, that He sees us, and that He's with us even today. Amen. Let's join together in prayer, family. Father, we thank You for Your words of truth. We thank You for this book of wisdom, Proverbs. We thank You for Your love and Your mercies. We thank You for the goodness of who You are. We've all made mistakes and lived foolishly. We've all made mistakes and walked by sight. We've all made mistakes and walked in the flesh and not of Your Spirit, Lord. I just ask that You forgive us all from where we've fallen short and not lived as You would have us to live or have been as You would have us to be, even as Your children, even as professing Christians, even as those who love You and fear You and want to know You more. Help us to overcome our flesh. Help us to overcome our unbelief. Help us to overcome our short-sightedness. Help us to live by faith and to walk in Your grace, in Your ways, in Your truth, in Your love. Help us to be what You would have us to be. Your will be done, not our own. Help us to pick up our crosses and follow You and die to ourselves daily and live for Thine kingdom, not our own, that Your kingdom would come here on earth as it is in heaven, Father God. We thank You that Your name is holy above all. May You give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, our transgressions, our trespasses, as we forgive those who sin against us, trespass against us, and transgress against us, Lord. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil, Father, and the evil one. For this is Your glory, this is Your power, this is Your honor forever and evermore. In the name and in the power and authority of Your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray and we praise You and we thank You for Your presence and Your goodness. Amen. I thank You for joining me through this study. I love you all because our Father God has loved us first. May the Lord continue to bless you and keep you, make His face shine upon you, being gracious to you, giving you His peace and His shalom, His complete wholeness through Christ Jesus. And I'll see you in the next audiobook segment or the next video segment, wherever the Lord leads us according to His plan and purpose. Lord willing, until then, amen.